How you doing, guys? Dragon Man here. I'm in my machine shop, and right now it's winter, and it's Harley Davidson rebuilding season. That's what we do back here. I do a lot of motors. So anyway, this is the deal that we do for $1,000. It's called the Rebuild Your Own Motor. You just send in your lower end. See that? You pack it in a plastic milk crate, put rags in the flywheel so it won't rotate, and put cardboard around it. It'll weigh around 55, 60 pounds. It'll go UPS. Your two cylinders and your two heads, you're putting two separate boxes. See that? Each head and each cylinder should be in a cardboard box that they don't hit each other and break the fins. So what we do, let me tell you what we do here. We take the whole thing apart. We glass bead the cases like this. I go through the oil pump, check the breather gear. We give you a three-hole crank pin. If you want to put a high lift cam in there, we sell those, Andrew's cams. It comes with a top end gasket set, and we use Hastings cast rings. They seat within 50 miles. We give you stock cast 8.5-to-1 compression pistons for the early motors. You get a rebuilt rod set with new bushings, races, pinion shaft bearings, cam bearing, and Timken bearings. Plus, I balance the flywheels. If you want to shave the flywheels, it's only $75 extra. You'll get faster RPMs. Yeah, look how smooth that turns. See that? Zero tolerance. Look at that. They don't even move. See that? Sideways. That's how you tell if your motor needs a rebuild by the rods going back and forth. There's 54 Torrington roller bearings on the crank pin, and they wear out fast. Okay, over here, I bore out the cylinders. See the next size over? See a nice 350 stone cross hatch. If you want the cylinders wrinkle finish like this guy did, we put them in the oven. With the heads, we give you a two-angle valve job. We give you AMCO guides, Teflon seals, and stainless steel nitrated valves. See how nice it comes out? And we set the spring tension on the valve springs. See, these are the AMCO guides for the unleaded gas. See that? Stainless steel nitrated valves. And for a little extra money, $30 a seat, we put solid nickel alloyed seats in here. They're like lifetime seats. They'll never wear out. It's real good for the heat with the unleaded gas. Okay, if you have any questions about this, you know, give me a call. Nothing stays in my shop more than 5 days. We knock them out. My number is 719-683-2200. The main thing is you got to pack it really good. So I got a little time. Let me just show you the equipment I use to do all this. Everything is done right here. Nothing gets farmed out like other shops. This is my lathe. Most of the time, all it does is cut down cylinders. See, this is a stock 8.5-to-1 compression cast Harley Davidson piston. We're going to make this 9.5, even 10.5. Now, how are we going to do that? Let me show you. I put it on my lathe here. It's all set up. See, there's the micrometer over here. We're going to go into the gasket surface 50 thousandths of an inch. I do 25 thousandths at a time. Every time I take 50 thousandths of an inch off the head gasket surface, it equals another 1.5-to-1 compression. So if we take 100 thousandths off, the 8.5-to-1 compression piston will be 10.5-to-1. I don't recommend any higher than that because of the gas they're selling now. But you have to remember, if you do cut down the cylinder or shave the head, you're going to have to definitely get adjustable push rods and cut down the manifold just a little bit. Because the twin cylinders, as you go down, the head gets closer to each other, and the manifold has to be cut a little too. So if you want more compression, that's the cheapest way to do it. This is my biggest lathe I have. It's like 20 horsepower. And what we do with this most of the time is shave down early flywheels. This is an early 1972 shovel head flywheel assembly. Okay, if you notice, look how thick this side is and how thin this is. So what we do is we take off a 1/2 inch of metal off this flywheel right here. And that's about, let's see, just give you an idea. Okay, so all the metal from the right side of the flywheel here is going to be shaved off. And what that does is it gives the motor, gives you faster RPMs, faster throttle response, because it doesn't have to move all that weight. it's an extra like 2.5 to 3 pounds we remove, just like stroker flywheels. I recommend that. And then your new timing mark will be a hole, a quarter inch hole going right through the flywheel. And then we rebalance it to whatever pistons you decide to use. This is my Sonnen Seatmaster machine I use a lot. And see, I made these fixtures over here. They hold, they can hold a Sportster head, a shovel head, and a pan head. And we just bolt the head right here. It's already at the right angle. See, this is air operated. See, this floats on air pistons. See that? See how nice? And what it will do is it centers itself over the valve guide hole. See? And this 3/8 pilot for a shovel head or a pan head follows the valve guide hole. And these are the cutters. It's all set up with a micrometer. And I leave a 3 to 4 thousandths interference fit. So the seat presses in there. Plus we have to heat up the seat so it expands, you know, the metal. And this goes underneath like that. And all we do is push the buttons here. And gotta put the switch on. And it'll go down. Right? And it's different speeds. I could put a seat in like 2.5 minutes. So this is the shovel head intake. This is the Sportster intake. And then we got the shovel head and pan head exhaust. You know, different cutters for different seats. The more tools I have, the more machines I have, the faster I could do everything, and the faster the jobs come and go. This Bridgeport mill machine is specifically just to put double spar plugs in every Harley-Davidson head. Okay, see, I made all kinds of jigs to hold the heads. See, this jig here would go right on here, see, like that, and then I'd center it on the opposite side of the head. So we're going to put a double spark plug in, here like that, and see, this cuts away the fin, the aluminum, and these are quick change attachments. Yeah, see, I just put this tool in here, go like that, take the next tool, put it in here like that, see that, tighten it up, and a new tool is in there. I could put a double spark plug in a head in less than 6 minutes. Each head. This is my welding area. This is my welding bench, and I could weld every kind of metal. I could do MIG, TIG, ARC. We have 4 welding machines over here, and over the years I got really good welding aluminum cases. And if you need any kind of case repair, 99% of the time I could fix it. Okay guys, this is my motor testing stand. I probably made this like 40 years ago. You know, to show the customers that the motor runs, I could adjust everything, it doesn't leak, and this way they give me less headaches, if you know what I mean. Okay, so anyway, this motor stand could start every Harley-Davidson motor, 1999 and down. Those are the ones I like to work on. I like to work on the early stuff. It takes about 10-15 minutes to hook it all up. This way we could set the timing. Tighten up the head, 65 pounds on the head bolts. I could make sure we got good oil pressure. This is an oil tank I made, a gas tank, and that's a Vegas starter flywheel and starter motor. All I do is hook up the 12 volt battery, push the button. We got 2 coils here, one for points and one for electronic ignition. But the thing is, I don't really like doing complete motors anymore, because it costs the customers a lot of money to ship them back on a trucking company, and I have to build a wooden box, you know, to put the motor in, and it takes a lot of time. That's why you should do the rebuild your own motor. If you need help putting the heads on, the cylinders, adjusting the push rods, I'm always here. You can always call me and I'll help you on the phone. You guys, it'll be like half price. For $1,000, you could have your motor rebuilt, parts and labor. And all you have to do is, when you get it home, is assemble the top end, adjust the push rods, put the carburetor and manifold on, and you have a $2,500 motor job. Hey guys, you're probably wondering what this machine does. Every machine in my shop has a purpose. Okay, this rebuilds, hones out connecting rods. It hones out the bushing, it hones out the main race, and this is the way it works. See, you put your mandrel in there, see, with a stone on it. See, like that. And you step on the pedal, see, and it goes back and forth. See, like that. And every time I go back and forth, it's taking out a little more metal. The hole is getting larger. To measure the hole that's getting larger, these are barrel indicators. See that? And that'll tell me when I get to the right size that I need. And the same thing with the wrist pin bushings. See, this measures the wrist pin bushings. See that? If you come around here, take a look. Look at that. Zero. See, that one's done. See, the highest point. Zero. See that? This is also used for line boring cases, honing out, could hone out valve guide holes, everything. I don't even own a Rema. Everything gets honed at Dragon Man's. This is a miller machine set up with a turntable. And the reason we have this all set up is because when the main races spin, you know, in a Harley case, I could cut the whole thing out and I put a new one in. And this machine, see, as I turn this, it goes around in a perfect circle and could cut the main race out. The 8 most popular pieces that break on a Harley Davidson case over the years, I had reproduced. So I could just about fix anything. This is my automatic honing machine. I actually have 7 honing machines. This one's fully automatic, as you could call it. It adapts to 130 mandrels. See, I have every one of them. From an eighth of an inch, 125 thousandths, to 6.5 inches. See that? Okay, so mainly what I do with this machine is bore out cylinders. A guy will come in with his cylinders. I put them in the machine here. We center it. See? The stones, the flutes open up, center the cylinder. We push this down. We mark how many thousandths of an inch we want taken out. See, we push the button. I put the oiler on, put it, lock it. See that? And see, it'll go back and forth by itself. Within about 3 to 4 minutes, the cylinder's bored out, 10 thousandths of an inch. See, you could never hold the cylinder that straight. Everything's measured with dial indicators. Here are 3 more of my honing machines. See, as you can see, everything is already set up. This has the, see the 3/8 mandrel in there. That's for the pan heads and the shovel heads to hone out the valve guides. Over here, we cross-hatch the cylinders after I hone them out. This is a fine stone, a 300 grit stone. That's for the Hastings cast rings. The rings will seat right away. On my automatic honing machine, we use a 100 grit stone, so it bores it out. That takes a lot more metal out at once. Over here, this is for Evolutions, and it's a 5/16 mandrel for Evolution valve guides and Sportsters. This here is my valve grinder machine. All the heads that come in here, the Dragon Man's, are done right here. These stones are already pre-cut, 30, 45, and 60 degrees. I could do a 3-angle valve job in about 12 minutes. See, this is the 1¾-inch stone. See, the pilot goes in there. See that, like that? The pilot will follow the valve guide in the head. And then this is air operated. Just goes on top like that. See that? And we just push this. And that's the way that works, and it cuts the seat. These are my homemade punches I made, probably about 40 years ago, and they were all heat treated. That means the metal is hardened. It'll last forever. So this is a cam bearing from a Harley shovel head. And all I do is put that on the case, hit the old one out, put the new one in here, hit the new one in. Okay, let's say I want to change the Timken bearing race. See, the sprocket shaft race, right? Okay, this one here, this one will put it, see, that'll take it out. See, we just hit it out. See that? And then we take the new race, put it on there, and we hit the new race right in. These punches are a lifesaver that really makes the jobs go a lot faster. So look at this line of miller machines. These are digital readout miller machines, and each one does a few different jobs. By leaving these all set up, it really saves probably about 2.5 hours a day by not having to set the machine up to do each job. This here cuts down the old seats. It's on the right angle, you know, for the shovel heads and pan heads. Okay, over here, this one here does a lot of jobs. When I weld up the motor mounts on a shovel head, a pan head, or a knucklehead, we bolt it right to this end plate here, and we could fly cut the motor mounts, or I could put the boring head in here and bore out the cases for 3 5/8 or 3 13/16 cylinders. Okay, this one here, this has 100 memories. This is a machine I use like all the time, almost every day. And what we do is for case repair, it locates all the holes after I weld them up. All the Harley Davidson blueprints are in the digital readout machine. All I do is locate on any hole, let's say the cam hole, the pinion shaft hole, the breather hole, and from that point on, it'll tell me how to get to the other holes. Okay, this machine here, when I weld up the valve guide hole, this is at the right angle for a shovel head and a pan head, and I start with a small drill, you know, like 3/8, and we go all the way up to 9/16, and that'll relocate the valve guide holes in aluminum heads. Okay, this milling machine, all this milling machine does is cut out the brass original seat on a pan head. See, for the intake, it's on the right angle. For the exhaust, we have the right angle. And these are special tools I had made. See, it's got a 3/8 hole in there where the 3/8 pilot goes in the middle of the end mill here, and that'll follow the valve guide. See, these flutes here are cut, specially cut, 3 to 4 thousandths smaller than the nickel seat that I'm going to install. And that'll make it fit really good. And after the seat is installed, I have to go to the valve grinder machine and do a 2 or 3 angle valve job. This digital readout right here shows me how deep I'm going. This is one of my boring bars, and what I use this one mostly for is to bore out Harley Davidson cases for big bore cylinders. And I raise the table up, and I could also countersink the heads for the big bore cylinders. Okay guys, well I hope you liked the tour of my shop. This is a one-man operation. I do all this stuff by myself. This way it comes out right the first time. I do have helpers here and there, you know, glass beading, taking things apart, washing parts, but all the machine work and assembly, I do myself. I also do top ends, you know, on twin cams, and we rebuild all the Harley Davidson transmissions. If you need any kind of this work done this winter, give me a call. I definitely give you the best deals and the best work available. My address is 1200 Dragon Man Drive. Any questions, give me a call, 719-683-2200. Have a great day.